Hello, Tay, Forges. I too long and hard about what to focus on in this material, and decided to discuss the little know and little understand topic of blob assets. The first sentence from the documentation is extremely important. Blob assets represent immutable binary data, because all the benefit of using blob assets and their performance comes from the fact that the data is read-only binary. In this sense, they are a great addition when passing data, because we can rewrite data from scriptable object to blob asset. But that's not all. If we have high-order filter coefficient, or a machine learning training set, or any other large data set, blob assets come to the rescue. Going forward, the data they contain must be value types. In addition to the standard value types, three special data types are supported: blob array, blob pointer, and blob string. Okay, enough theory. In the description I put a link to the documentation and encourage you to read it. And let's focus on the implementation of the working example. Let's start with the basics. We need a container to store collectibles data. In our case, it will be float points. So let's add a directory, blob assets, and inside it create struct collectible container with public float points variable. Next, let's create a struct collectible pool, which in turn will store a blob array of collectible containers. Since collectible container is a struct and has value types, we can pass it as a dynamic type to the blob array, and it will be understood by the compiler. So let's go one step further. We need to access our data from within the ECS, right? That's why we need to prepare collectible component data struct. Inside it, create a blob asset reference with the type of the previously created collectible pool. Finally, we can create the collectible afferent class, which obviously is mono behavior. We need to pass data from the scene, and in the future from scriptable object, but for the sake of the example, we simplify. Let it be a list of points for collectible collected by the player. So now let's create a baker, and inside the bake method, let's get an entity with the non-transfer flag. Write var collectible blob asset equal to create collectible blob asset afferent.collectibleData. Then let's start implementing the method private blob asset reference collectible pool, create collectible blob asset I read only list float collectible data. I can use I read only list because I don't need to modify any elements of the list within the method. And inside this method, the blob asset magic will begin, which is not at all as scary as it might seem, so let's go one step at a time. First of all, let's write using var builder equal new blob builder allocator.temp. Here, let's stop for a moment. First of all, by using keyword, we are guaranteed that after the completed operation, it is, in our case, return, blob builder will be disposed. Secondly, blob builder serves us only to create blob asset reference and later we'll no need it. That's why we are going to use allocator.temp. Next, let's create ref var collectible pool equal ref builder.construct root collectible pool. As you can see, I use ref keyword, any blob array, pool, blob string, etc. must be referred via reference, not value type. So let's allocate memory for blob array. Create blob array builder variable and pass parameters. The first will be collectible pool.collectibleData, that is our array, and the second will be the size of that array. Next, we want to fill the array with data. It is rewrite the list into the blob array. We use for and create new components in a loop, passing the points to the container variable. Finally, we can create a blob asset reference for collectible pool from the builder, where allocator is set to persistent because we don't want the data to be released from memory while the application is running. So now let's register the blob asset to the Baker via add blob asset ref collectible blob asset out underscore. We don't need to use hash, that's why I use discard variable. According to the documentation, if you don't register a blob asset to the Baker, the ref counting doesn't update and the blob asset could be deallocated unexpectedly. Don't forget to add our collectible component data with collectible blob array reference. The last thing to do, let's create a collectible system, which in this video we will use to test the operation of blob asset, so we get a minimal working example. Let's implement iSystem and iSystem start stop, and of course create missing members. Add the base compile attribute for each method, and at the top of the class. Also add update in group attribute, type of simulation system group. In the onCreate, let's just add required for update collectible component data. We want to test whether our system is running. For this, we'll use the onStartRunning method. Inside it, let's write var collectible component data equal systemapi.getSingleton collectible component data. Ref var collectible pool equal ref collectible component data.collectible pool reference.value. Ref blob array collectible container collectible data equal ref collectible pool dot collectible data. As you can see, I use ref everywhere according to the guidelines in the documentation, just to make sure that I always refer to the right place in the memory. What remains for us is to create a for loop and display the elements of the array in the console. Let's wait for the compilation process to finish, clear console from some editor errors, and go to the systems prefab, and create empty object, name it collectibles, then attach collectible affering component. So now let's add some numbers to the list so we have a way to test the result of the implementation. I think 6 numbers will be enough. Okay, let's run the game and see if we got the same numbers as we entered in the prefab. Let's have a look at the console. Yes, we got the correct results. We managed to correctly implement a minimal working example for blob asset. Good job! I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon. Even a small contribution will help to develop the channel and the quality of the content present. Link in the description. Thanks you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.